So I decided to continue on with my training of implementing Patty, who is Morgan's owner. And as you can see, Morgan was immediately hesitant to just step down from the get-go. This is my very first interaction, just bringing her out of her enclosure, bringing her into the house to work. And she's definitely more hesitant than normal. I mean, we eventually work through it, but this isn't normal from what you guys have seen in the past with it just being me and Morgan working.
Recording?
So Patty has a camera. She's videotaping for me. And so therefore she is right next to me. And this is just causing a major issue between me and Morgan being able to get repetitions in.
Yeah, let's go.
Okay, you're hesitating.
So I'm attempting to pick up where I left off with her skills, flying through a doorway. Coming to me, and the main issue that you're going to see here is that she's incredibly hesitant. She wants to come, you can tell by her body language, but she's just unwilling with Patty so close. So what I do is I back up, asking a hard flight, and then I go forward and ask an easy flight, which also creates distance between me and Patty, and that's when she's willing and not hesitant at all. Those of you that have been following my Morgan series from the very beginning will notice that when she's really, really hesitant about trying something, once I convince her to do it one time, she starts getting some serious momentum to just keep doing it and ignore the things that are bothering her. So here she's still hesitant to take a treat. She kind of just stares at Patty, her owner, when she lands and contemplates. But I just try to distract her not only with a treat but with walking away and creating that distance again between me and Patty so that Morgan is more likely to respond to me.
Good girl!
Nice job!
What a good job! You did so well. Ignore her. Jeez.
Pay no attention to the woman behind the curtain.
I know! Morgan!
So I ended up getting a couple good recalls in as far as Morgan being a lot less hesitant, but it only happened once Patty was off to the side and filming instead of directly behind me.
Come on, Morgan. Good girl.
Hey guys, Jamie and Patty here. I just wanted to come at you and fill in some of the blanks. A lot of you have been asking, why is Patty negative? Why does Morgan act the way she does around me and Patty when we're together? A little bit more negatively, a little bit more hesitant, and sometimes aggressive. So we just kind of wanted to fill in those blanks for you, for those of you that may not have read the blog posts or may not have followed every single video. So here's the backstory of Morgan and Patty.
Okay, first of all, I should tell you that Morgan's behavior is completely normal. If I were in her shoes, I would be feeling negatively too. Let me explain to you a little bit of how this all came to be. I had Morgan for about maybe 3 or 4 days before I took her to the vet, and she was having a toe amputated. And so, I mean, think of it from a bird's point of view. I take her to the vet, and she's returned to me with only part of her foot. That's not going to make me very popular in her eyes. And then I take her home. She doesn't want to take her medication. And because of the nature of the surgery that she had to have antibiotics and she had to have pain medications. And she wouldn't take them. And so I basically had to towel her for about 14 days and force them on her. I had her for, I'd say, another couple of months after that before she would even step up for me. We were working every day to rebuild the relationship, but it was really slow going. And, you know, if you've ever had a bird with a problem, you understand that it has to go at their speed. You can't force it. And I was doing what I could to, you know, like kind of hurry it along, but she just didn't trust me. My hands had never represented anything to her but force. So right before we were leaving to come to Idaho, Jamie and Dave were coming to pick up my cages. But that day, like a couple of days before that actually, I was on the floor playing with her. She was already stepping up for a couple of, maybe 6 weeks. She'd been, you know, trusting me enough to step up for me. Not always, still hesitant, but you know, we were making making a breakthrough. But I was actually on the floor playing with her for the first time ever. And I was like kind of batting around a wad of paper and she's hobbling after it. And it was a lot of fun. So I was kind of excited about us having this breakthrough. So Jamie and Dave come to Washington, and they pick up my cages, and they took Morgan with them then. And I think you've seen, you know, the videos of how everything went. Morgan kind of fell in love with Jamie. And so when I surface, it's like, oh, heck no. And so she's got this relationship with Jamie. She really would like to keep it that way. And so when I step into the picture, that's what you see. That's the hesitancy you see, and the resistance to come anywhere near me. And yeah, you know, it hurts. Jamie is gratefully taken over with the training and trying to get her into a position where she can just bond with humans in general, because she has not been handled properly in the past. And she needed a lot of work, and Jamie's been doing that. I'm a hindrance. So Jamie is trying to slowly work me into the picture. So what you see is Morgan being hesitant going anywhere where I am. That's pretty much to be expected. What you don't see is the work that I'm doing off camera with Morgan. In the morning, I go in and I target her around her cage. I step her up, I weigh her, I step her up again, put her back in the cage, and I feed her. So we are doing work as well. But that's only if Jamie's not in the room. I would not get the same, you know, behavior if you were around.
Even, I think it was yesterday, I was cleaning the bird area, and Morgan's in the same area as my birds. I'm cleaning in there, doing my thing, and Patty walks in, and she just kind of waits. She's like, well, I was going to weigh her, but do you think I should do that with you in the room? And I was like, I don't know. Do you think you should do that with me in the room?
No.
And she goes, no. I'm like, good girl. We'll make a trainer out of you. So the good thing about Patty is her instincts. Like, she definitely can tell and read Morgan really, really well. So she knows when she's uncomfortable, and she knows how much to push it, which is half the battle, honestly, is just being aware of all those things. So having to teach someone what those signals are is really difficult. So I'm glad I don't have to at least do that with Patty. At this point, I'm just directing and training them both at the same time and incorporating Patty as much as I can without hindering my progress with Morgan. So she's not a part of every single session, as you'll see. I ended up doing a session without her because I wanted to see progress. No offense.
Oh, man.
Yeah, no offense. So she's not a part of every single session. I feel like that would really lag our sessions down. But she is just enough to keep it so that I want her relationship with Patty to go in a positive direction. I don't want it to just stay neutral. So, and it is, mm-hmm. It is. So she doesn't step up every time still, but we're gonna get there. And I'm really excited for you guys to share the journey with us and just check it out. So.
And ideally, the goal is, you know, we would love to be able to fly her back and forth between us.
Yeah.
But there is a plan in place for Jamie to transfer Morgan's affections back to me. And I'm not going to be staying in the background forever.
No.
My bird. But so we have a plan in place to switch her back over to me. And we're on track, I'd say.
We're totally on track. It takes some time, as you guys see. Like, I've had a ton of progress, but everything takes time. So the goal is far ahead still. And I'm hoping to have her flying outdoors by this fall.
So excited. I mean, all of this leads to a great life for Morgan. And as much as I hate the fact that my bird doesn't like me right now, and I'm getting that big old lump in my throat talking about it, it's for the best. She's going to have an amazing life.
Yeah. And she's going to look so pretty free flying with my boys.
Yeah. And all this will have been very worth it.
Yeah. Okay. I've decided to do one more session tonight because Morgan was so hesitant with Patty around, and Patty was actually videotaping, so she was behind me the whole time, which hasn't really happened. And I just felt like Morgan was not digging that scenario. So I'm going to go get her and try a second session without anybody. Dave and Capri are at the grocery store. Patty is doing her thing, writing some blog posts or something. So it's just me, and it could just be me and Morgan. So I'm going to try and see what happens and see if there's a big difference, or if maybe today she's just hesitant on every front, because some days could be like that. So I went and got Morgan, and she was still incredibly hesitant to step down, even with just me and her in the room. I'm not sure if she just didn't believe that it was only me and her, and it took some time to convince her, or if this was just the type of day that she was having, but I was determined to work through it and get some sort of positive result from the entire day. All right, so this is totally new. She hasn't come from this direction yet. I'm gonna see what happens.
What do you think? Can you come? Morgan, come on. Just me and you. Come on, Morgan. Oh, let's go. Come on, girl. Good job. Morgan! Good job. Good girl. Cool.
Let's work on some different flights. All right, we're just gonna go back to basics. Work on some fun stuff that she already knows. Because that was really awesome where she flew the opposite direction through that doorway. So now I just want to do some fun stuff that she's already good at so we can just have a fun session together. Just me and you. Ready? Morgan. Yeah, come on. Good job. So at this point, I knew I had to do something to change it up because I needed a better response. She was being incredibly hesitant, more so than usual.
I'm gonna bring in some competition.
I think she's just having a super hesitant day. So I don't know if it was all Patty and started there or what. Ooh, tried to get up on my shoulder. We're gonna give you one. I don't know if it stemmed from starting it off with Patty in that way or what, but I'm going to go grab Jinx, my blue-throated macaw, and see how she does with a little competition, if it makes her respond faster, because this lagging is just not cool.
I go into depth about this training tactic in my indoor flight training course, which is available at birdtrickstore.com. But basically what I'm doing is Jinx already knows the name of the game. And the name of the game is the bird that responds the fastest to my call gets the reward. And so Morgan's about to learn this game, and I'm hoping that it will increase her response time to where she is then the quickest bird.
Response.
Hey girl, get ready. Get ready, stay ready. Jinxie. Good boy. Morgan. Yeah, that's how fast he responds, huh?
You can see how observational learning really plays a huge role in this game when using a bird that already knows how to play, like Jinx. So there, Morgan understood that she lost her opportunity to earn that treat because Jinx responded faster, even though it was her cue. So at the end of that last clip, I didn't call Jinx and he came anyway, and that's what Morgan just did. So that observational learning is definitely playing a role. So I don't think Morgan knew that it was a part of the game that you could still come after one bird had already landed on the person. So here she kind of gets a glimpse at that, which makes her a little bit uncomfortable, but it is a learning process, so she seems open to it. Since I am planning to free fly her with my other birds, there's going to be times where she needs to be able to land on me when other birds are on me already. So this is incorporating that part.
It's okay. Healthy competition. Good job. What's spooking you? Good girl. You guys did so, so good. Guess what that means? Wherever I put those walnuts, I was going to give you some, but I can't find it right now. Where are those walnuts? All right, that was a success. Thank you.